In a world consumed by negativity, where problems seem insurmountable and hope is in short supply, one man has risen above it all. Victor Zane, a military veteran, public servant, and cancer survivor, knows what it's like to face adversity head on. He's been through the darkest of days and emerged stronger and more resilient. Now, he's on a mission to inspire others to do the same. Join Victor on his journey through the highs and lows of life as he shares his story and the lessons he's learned along the way. From communication breakdowns to emotional distancing, Victor knows the toll negativity can take on relationships. But he also knows the power of positivity and how it can transform lives. In his podcast, Zane Talk, Victor invites you to discover the tools and strategies you need to overcome negativity and build strong, supportive relationships. Through expert interviews, personal anecdotes, and practical tips, Victor will guide you on a journey of personal growth and emotional intelligence. So buckle up and get ready for the ride of your life. The road ahead may be bumpy, but with Victor Zane by your side, you can face any challenge with confidence and resilience. So join the Zane Talk community today and discover the power of positivity.
Welcome, everyone, to Zane Talk with Victor Zane. It's been a long time, but we're back. Great to see everybody here. It's time to ditch the negativity and embrace the power of positivity. Welcome to Zane Talk, the positivity powerhouse, your one-stop destination for all things inspiring, empowering, and truly transformational. Don't miss out on this new era of talk radio and podcasting. Subscribe now and let Victor guide you on the path to a happier, healthier, and more successful life. What's going on, everybody? How is everybody doing today? Go over to www.victorzane.com. Sorry, zanetalk.com. Go over to zanetalk.com. Do yourself a favor and look at all we have to offer over there on our platform. Thanks for joining us today here. I'm working some tweaks out here on the board, so bear with me if it sounds a little bit distorted. How's everybody doing today? It's a great day in the neighborhood, like it always is. So, I want to talk about a couple of things today here on the show. Now, I haven't had a show for a very long time. I haven't had a show here on Zane Talk for quite a while. So, with that said, there we go. We tweaked it a little bit better. That should sound a lot better in regards to the audio now. Sorry about that. But we haven't had a show for a very long time, so I decided to put one up. I'm going to shoot from the hip today. But I want to talk about a couple of things that we deal with in our everyday life. Discipline is one of them. Discipline happens to be one of the powerhouse principles, I call powerhouse principle, that is really hard to master. And I'm going to give you some tips, and we're going to talk about discipline, and we're also going to talk about how to stay motivated in a negative world and the impact of positivity versus negativity. So, hey, let's get started. Wow. Why does discipline matter? How does it positively impact our lives? And more importantly, how can we cultivate it? We'll explore the answers to these questions and more. So grab a cup of coffee or a beer or a Kool-Aid or whatever you're into. Settle in and let's get started. When you hear the word discipline, what comes to mind? How does it impact positively in our lives? And more importantly, how can we cultivate it? What is it? It is a strict regimen, a military-like regimen, or is it freedom? That's right, freedom. Seems counterintuitive, doesn't it? But as we'll discover today, discipline, the ability to pursue one thinks is right despite temptations to abandon it, is the direct definition, by the way, is often the foundation for freedom and success. Listen, our journey into discipline begins with understanding the why. Why should we choose discipline over comfort, convenience, and immediate gratification? Well, you know, there's an old saying, discipline weighs ounces, but regret weighs tons. Essentially, the small, consistent effort it takes to be disciplined far outweighs the heavy burden of regret. Whether it's health, whether it's wealth, whether it's learning, whether it's relationships, an area of life, discipline always plays a key role. It's like compounding interest, small, consistent actions building upon one another over time, you know, eventually leading to, or can lead to, very remarkable results. So what drives discipline? Let's look at three primary motivational factors. And these are very important. I want you to pay particular attention to what I say in this, because it's very important to learn these. Hey, Deb, how are you? Nice to see you. So there are three. And understanding these three can be very pivotal in, and I don't want to say conquering, but I want to say mastering discipline. First, it's intrinsic motivation. Intrinsic motivation is the internal desire to do something. It doesn't matter what it is, just do it. It's what fuels our passion. It's what ignites our curiosity and drives us to accomplish our goals for personal satisfaction or fulfillment. I'll tell you what, think of a hobby you love, or maybe a personal project you've taken on simply because it brings you joy. These things in itself, the joy from doing it, the butterflies you get from doing these things, that is intrinsic motivation. The second, extrinsic motivation. Extrinsic motivation is driven by external rewards or threats of punishment. It can be the promise of a promotion, the fear of job loss, or simply social recognition. Now, yeah, I understand that may seem very negative in context, but it's not. Think about not completing your project, or think about not completing or doing a hobby you love. It's kind of like punishing yourself internally, not only internally, but externally. And the outcome that you could derive from these things could be exponentially remarkable. And lastly, there's discipline's secret weapon. Habit. Habit is discipline's best friend. Over time, repeated actions become automated responses, and the effort it takes to maintain a disciplined routine diminishes. Repetitiveness. Doing it over and over and over again until, you heard the phrase, practice makes perfect. You consistently repeat things until they become second nature. That's what discipline's secret weapon is. Habit. It's discipline's best friend. Now, how does discipline positively impact our lives? Well, first, discipline brings structure and predictability. A disciplined life, of course, is less chaotic. It's less stressful, and it provides a sense of stability and order, which is beneficial for our mental health. Now, you understand that mental health plays a huge part in this. It plays a huge part in discipline, and discipline can be better for your mental health. Discipline can be better for your mental health. Yeah, you heard it here. Second, discipline leads to self-confidence and higher self-confidence and higher self-esteem. Accomplishing goals, no matter how small, I mean, think about it, can bring a tremendous sense of achievement and you know, each of those wins, that builds self-confidence within you. It makes you want to get out there. It makes you want to do things. It's like, man, I won. I got out there. Yeah, I did this or I did that, and I accomplished that. Let me go on to the next obstacle. I defeated this obstacle. Now let me go to this obstacle. And next thing you know, and next, what happens is you create a pyramid of success. You create layers of success, and you create a foundation for discipline. And third, discipline can also lead to mastery and expertise. It's the driving force behind deliberate practice, the key to becoming better, if not the best at what you do. Wouldn't you want to become the best at what you do? I mean, you've heard of subject matter experts, right? Subject matter experts are these people that have mastered all three of these discipline approaches. Habit. Repetitiveness over and over again, okay? Self-confidence, self-esteem, and of course, mastery and expertise. These all are very positive effects that affect our life in a very positive manner. Hey, Roxanne, how are you? Very good. By the way, everybody, go check out her Twitch feed. It's called Foxy Roxy over on Twitch. It's an awesome, she games and talks and gives commentary on the game. It's very good, so get over there and support her. So how do we cultivate discipline? It's very simple. You start small. You celebrate your wins, and you build consistency. Consistency is key to this. You have to be consistent. You have to do it, and you have to stick to it. I'm guilty of this. Procrastination is my biggest enemy. And sometimes, you know, you don't feel like doing it, but those are the times that you have to get up off your ass and go do it. So you start small, you celebrate your wins, and you build consistency. You have to understand your why. Find your intrinsic motivation and build habits around it. Seek out accountability if you struggle to stay on track. And remember, discipline is not about perfection, but persistence. Listen, find out somebody to keep you accountable, to keep you held accountable. Find somebody or hold yourself accountable. Stay on track. I mean, come on, you got your vision, you got your goal in front of you. Now, I'm a big believer in vision boards, by the way. I believe vision boards, if you're building a business or you have a goal in mind or you're doing a project or so on and so forth, a vision board, and if you don't know what a vision board is, Google it. It's awesome. Maybe I'll do an excerpt on next show about vision boards. But vision boards, I believe, are pivotal, very pivotal in trying to help you maintain your discipline. And it gives you your roadmap to your goals and your successes. And you can see yourself actually achieving those successes. And it'll actually keep you on track. A vision board is definitely one tool that can keep you on track. And again, it's not about being perfect. You don't have to be perfect, all right? Discipline is not about being perfect. It's about being persistent. You keep plugging your way through. You know, you might run into some walls here and there. You might run into some barriers or obstacles. But like we said before, you have to go through these obstacles and go through them or try to find a way over them. And in itself, you will not only defeat that obstacle, but you will be on that next tier of success. And it's very simple, folks. It's very simple. So there you have it, folks. A look at motivating factors of discipline and the positive impacts it has on our lives. And remember, discipline isn't a destination. It's a journey. It's a daily choice to, you know, choose long-term gain over short-term pleasure. It's a path to freedom. It's a path to your freedom. Now, remember, ladies and gentlemen, I said this is probably going to be about a 20-minute show. That's all right. You know, I'm shooting from the hip today, and I want everybody to understand that shooting from the hip, sometimes you just kind of go with the flow, and whatever comes into your head, is basically what I'm talking about today is things that I've actually read or I've mulled over in my head, and I was like, you know what, this would be a good topic to talk about today because I'm very well versed on these you know, particular topics. And I think that these three topics in itself are very important in everyday life. Listen, Roxy, of all people, can tell you. Roxy, if you guys don't know Roxy, again, go visit her Twitch. I think it's called Foxy Roxy. Roxanne, you're more than welcome to put your Twitch information in the chat. And hey, ladies and gentlemen, if you're listening on the replay, please feel free to comment on chat. And don't forget to share the show out. There is a little share button. And also follow us on Spreaker. That would really help us. Hit the little, there's a little a heart or a thumbs up, I believe, on Spreaker as well. You know, do that. It boosts our numbers up. And share us on your Facebook page or share us on your social media. Put something in the description and say, hey, check this guy out. He's talking about discipline. He seems to know what the heck he's talking about. So our other topic, it's how to stay motivated in a negative world and the impact of positivity versus negativity. Listen, the world is all full of negativity. All you have to do is open up the news. You see, like today, I opened up the news and boom, there it was. Nuclear war is all over the place, all right? And I'm not going to get into politics. I'm actually going to have a separate show and talk about politics. I'm going to call it, I'll call it something, Zane Talks Politics or some shit like that. I'm not sure what I'm going to call it, but we'll figure it out. But the world is very negative. No matter where you go, no matter who you talk to, it just seems like everybody's like down and out. I got this going on. Gas prices are way up, and you know, it's my grocery bill, my electric bill, everything's went up tenfold because of this and because of that. The world is a very negative place. You turn on the TV, you flip over, a newspaper, you open a newspaper. If you still listen or you still read, newspapers, you open up the newspaper or you get on your Kindle or your tablet and you read the news. I read the news either on my cell phone as well. So there are all these avenues of approach for technology to read the news. However you consume the news or consume your information, the world, you're right, Debbie, the world is completely negative and it's very disheartening. And, you know, it's very hard to find a feel-good story nowadays. If you look, most of the feel-good stories are buried, probably in the 10th or 15th page, I would imagine, of any news source. Or even if you have a news, a local news, people that you listen to, you very rarely find any good feel-good news stories. So we live in a world where negativity is all too common. We see it, like I said, in the news. We see it on social media and even in our day-to-day lives. It can be disheartening, and sometimes it just seems, I don't know, overwhelming. But remember, there is one thing that's really prevalent about this. We have the power to change our mindset and to navigate through this negativity. Yes, you heard that. We have the power to do this. Each and every one of you out there listening to this podcast, each and every one of you that listens to us over on Patreon and sees the behind the scenes, not only the behind the scenes, the special shows that I have over there, the personal power of positivity shows that I do over there, you see this and you have that choice to navigate through all this negativity. What we feed our minds can significantly impact how we perceive the world and how we feel on a daily basis. I mean, when we're exposed to negativity, it can lead to feelings of despair. You can feel hopelessness, and it definitely can erode our motivation. I mean, there's times where, you know, you're just like, I don't want to do this. I don't feel like doing this. Oh, I don't, you know, I get up in the world. It's just blah, blah. I don't feel like it's just, I'm so sad and I'm so depressed. And it's like, pick yourself up. Feelings of despair are normal. Feelings of hopelessness are normal. And yes, it can erode our motivation. But on the other hand, positive thinking opens us up to opportunities. It enhances our motivation and can also improve our overall mental well-being. Think about it. Everything that we think about, too many things in that one. Everything that has a negative also has a positive. So keep that in the back of your head. You may be feeling all down and about, but there's always, you heard the silver lining in a cloud and the silver lining in every cloud. That little, I know I've been doing some metaphors here during this show, but they're spot on, for this hip shoot. So yeah, I mean, it opens us up to a plethora of different mindsets. And again, that's how your vision board can also come into effect when you're, you can actually apply the vision board to this as well, because your vision board, as you see yourself, maybe getting a little disparaged and a little down and a little depressed, you know, you can look at your vision board and say, you know what? I just did this. I wonder what it would be like if I completed this, or I'm getting to my goal here. Your vision board is one of those tools that we can reinvigorate your motivation, to get back on track. And, you know, and of course your overall mental well-being can definitely improve. So how do we stay motivated amid all this negativity? It's important to remember that motivations, it's not a one-time thing. It's an ongoing process, ladies and gentlemen. The first step is to limit your exposure to negativity. It's everywhere. I know it's hard to get away from, but the first step in completing this is to try to find a way to be rid of it or lessen it in your life. This can mean taking a break from the news, like we said, you know, taking a break from social media. Setting boundaries with negative individuals can also help, not only in the workplace, but in your personal life, okay? And so that can also help. And believe it or not, ladies and gentlemen, your comments in the comment section here really do help us boost our ratings up on the Spreaker platform. So I really do appreciate that. Also, the shares do. Also, hitting the heart button, liking it, also boosts us up. So we really appreciate that. So yeah, setting boundaries with negative individuals and setting boundaries, period, and saying, no, I am not going to wake up today being negative. Listen, our thoughts can be our biggest motivators and our biggest demotivators. So adopt a growth mindset. Embrace failures as learning opportunities. Practice gratitude and challenge any negative self-talk. Replace I can't with I can. How about that? Or if you can't, or if you want to replace I can't, you can replace it I can't blank yet, for instance. Yet is a key word in there, okay? I always say I'm an American. So that's one of my little catchphrases. I love it and it works. But I mean, listen, you got to adopt a growth mindset. I mean, you know, our mind is our biggest enemy. Another metaphor, our mind is our biggest enemy. It's our biggest obstacle that we have to overcome. How am I sounding out there, by the way, ladies and gentlemen? Hopefully I'm sounding good. Our mind is our biggest enemy. And if we can conquer it, if we can control it, if we can use those disciplinary steps that I talked about earlier in the program here, you can apply that to this and be on a better path for sure. I mean, it's interesting how much a small shift in perspective can affect our motivation. And let's not forget the power of goal setting. Having a clear vision of what you want to keep, having a clear vision of staying on track and how you motivate yourself, even in a sea of negativity, can be the difference. I mean, also celebrating small victories like we talked about before along the way can give you the motivation that you need to keep going. I mean, come on, think about it. If you're giving yourself, and I'm saying treat yourself, talk about talk to people, promote yourself. Go out there and talk to your friends. Look what I accomplished today, and look what I did today with this. And man, I felt really great because I was able to accomplish this. I felt really great because I was able to get over this obstacle, and so on and so forth. I mean, self-promotion is key because you're reaffirming to yourself that yeah, you're doing it. You're kicking ass and taking names. And you're staying on track and you're being consistent, all right? And goal setting is another reason or another way that you can do that. I mean, having a clear vision of what you want can keep you motivated and on track. Also, celebrating small victories. I mean, come on. Think about it. It's one of the best ways. But positivity isn't just about being happy all the time either. Being positive doesn't mean ignoring your feelings or pretending everything is perfect. It's about acknowledging your feelings, understanding that it's okay to have bad days, and then choosing to focus on the positives and opportunities for growth, thus turning those bad days into good days. You have the precipice to set your day when you wake up. If you wake up in a crappy mood, you're going to have a crappy day. If you wake up in a great mood, you're going to have a great day. It is up to you, ladies and gentlemen, what you want to do in regards to that. You don't ignore your feelings. You don't pretend everything is perfect. You're going to have your ups and downs. It's a big roller coaster ride. I mean, you're up and down all the time. Life, you're up and down all the time. So just embrace your feelings. Channel the positivity. Set clear goals and always remember, you have the power to choose your perspective. You do. Let me say that again. Embrace your feelings. Let me remember this. Yeah. Embrace your feelings. Channel your positivity. Set clear goals and always remember, you have the power to do what? Choose your perspective. Listen, I want to thank everybody for tuning in with me tonight. Let's keep the conversation going. How do you stay motivated? Share your thoughts and experiences with us below, or you can email me at victorzane101@gmail.com and let me know how do you stay motivated. And remember, no matter how negative the world seems, the power to stay positive lies within you, ladies and gentlemen. It certainly does. Thanks for tuning in to this episode of Zane Talk. If you found value in today's podcast, don't forget, share it with a friend. Share it on your social media. Share it out. Say something in the description. Tell people, get over there, listen to this guy, and share this guy. And if you haven't already, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Get over to YouTube. Just do Zane Talk. Do a search for Zane Talk. You'll see me. Or Victor Zane. Zane Talk will probably be better. Subscribe to the podcast. Subscribe to the podcast here on Spreaker. You can also catch us on iHeartRadio, Spotify, and many other venues and stay updated on our newest episodes. Plus, we have another thing called the Victor Mindset, which also we upload. It's not live. We upload that, and that goes to Spreaker here as well, and it goes out to all the other all the other venues, and you can listen to that. And that's usually a 5 to 6 minute excerpt on a topic, and we put some music behind it. So thanks for tuning in. I really appreciate it. I hope you found value in today's podcast. Let me tell you something. And remember, you have within you right now everything you need to deal with whatever the world can throw at you. Also, remember this. In a world of negativity, be a victor. Have a great night, everybody. Thanks for joining in. See you next time.